What? We have an update on Aaron Rodgers' status with the Packers, but of course we start the show with NBA Finals Game 3 between the Suns and the Bucks, and Giannis Antetokounmpo was not to be stopped last night. Another dominant performance in the NBA Finals, this time in a win to get the Bucks to 2-1 in the series. Jalen, what did you think about the Greek Freak?
Extremely dominant, historically, and Jacoby. So a lot of times, people try to look at the warts in Giannis's game. And like almost 95% of seven-footers, he's not an accurate three-point shooter.
No.
Like many seven-footers, he's not a great free throw shooter. No. He was making them last night, actually. He sped up his free throw routine. But other than that, he's like the perfect basketball specimen. I'm talking about his athleticism, his competitiveness, his leadership, but also his dominance. And so he does it in all facets. He does it defensively, guarding multiple positions. He does it offensively, driving left, driving right, playing on the left side of the floor, playing at the top of the floor, finding cutters, being an assist guy, getting DeAndre Ayton in foul trouble.
Yep.
Returning from a hyperextended knee in game one that I didn't believe he was going to play, and have back-to-back 40-plus in 10 games. It's been incredible to watch Giannis, his agility, and his ability to be so very productive in these NBA Finals.
The Suns have absolutely no answer for Giannis Antetokounmpo in this series, which is clear after scoring 42 in Game 2 and 41 in Game 3 in the win. But, Jalen, you touched on something that I want to talk about. We're going to talk about the offense and how they can't stop him, but what he does defensively for this team is so important to their success. He is not just a rim protector. He's a rim protector, and he's a guy who can guard on the perimeter. He solidifies this defense and keeps the Suns from getting to their spots and getting what they want, and we saw that in the play of Devin Booker last night as well. But, Jalen, Giannis wasn't the only one contributing for the Bucks. Drew Holiday, who has been, his name has been slandered for the past 3 days. He played well last night. What do you think about Drew showing up?
It was great to see him aggressive. That's what I like to see. And the way he competes defensively, and he made a concerted effort to pick up CP3 full court.
Yep.
I like when he's aggressive offensively. Look at the step back three-pointer he made at the top of the floor. And then look at the one he made at the top on the left side early in the clock. He was playing in front of the chains, as they would say in football. And so him being aggressive, their backcourt, he and Middleton, were thoroughly outscored by CP3 and Devin Booker in games 1 and 2.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Much so, the Suns' backcourt took turns in games 1 and 2 scoring at least 30. Last night, neither one of them cracked 20. It was also done defensively. And I give them a lot of credit because it was a much needed, clearly obvious opportunity for them to try to win, because we all know if they would have went down 0-3, I didn't want to be that guy in Milwaukee in front of the Deer District with my Wallys. I ain't want to have to be that guy in front of 20,000, 25,000 people. Now I don't have to.
Well, that is certainly the case. In Game 1 and Game 2, it just felt like the Suns got whatever they wanted whenever they wanted. They went 20 for 40 from 3 in Game 2. And you knew that that was going to change when they got to Milwaukee. But also, the Bucks stepped up. Bobby Portis Jr. stepped up. Someone who has not really been a shining star for this team during the season is showing up in the playoffs. And he had a big game last night. What do you think of Portis?
Well, the thing is, like, they don't look at him as a member of the Big 3. But he's played an important role all year. And they're also without one of their starters in Dante DiVincenzo. Mm-hmm. So Porter, 40% three-point shooter, can post up against smaller guys or people his size and score with his back to the basket. He has a soft touch. You just saw that in finishing in the paint. But also he gives them a level of toughness and enthusiasm that the crowd feeds off of. That's the difference between being on the road versus home. He getting Bobby chance in front of their home fans who appreciate his effort.
Jalen, you and I, if it feels like 3 million years ago, but you and I were talking about this Phoenix Suns team in their series against the Nuggets, that getting DeAndre Ayton in foul trouble was going to be very important because they're so thin up front. It just never really happened. DeAndre Ayton did a great job of staying out of foul trouble, but last night he picked up four fouls. He had to sit on the bench, and we see what happens when he goes to the bench. The Bucks just absolutely feasted on offense. Jalen, how important is it for him to stay on the floor in game four?
Now follow me here, because this game, it might go over some of y'all head. So he was able to stay out of foul trouble against the Joker one single tower. Against the Bucks, they have 2 7-footers in Giannis clearly and Brooke Lopez. Against Denver, who was without Murray, Sarge was actually healthy then. Now without him, he's a capable three-point shooter. He gives you 6 fouls. So now they're down a body against a guy that's been a two-time MVP versus the Joker, who won it this year. And so you're right. It's imperative for him to stay on the floor, because the first, I guess, 15 minutes is when he scored his 18 points. When he went out of the game, that's when Milwaukee got on their run. And then they carried that momentum. Yeah, Phoenix made a slight run, but then drew his couple of three-point shots, put him back at bay. But Giannis' constant dominance and defensive effort was definitely the key for Milwaukee.
Yeah, I mean, Giannis Antetokounmpo is putting his stamp on this series. You saw it in game two. Even in a loss, he had 42. In this game, he had 41. It just feels like if Giannis can impose his will and he can get contributions from Holiday and Portis and Middleton like he did last night, this is going to be a completely different series. After the Suns went up 2-0, it kind of felt like this was going to be a coronation of Chris Paul. This is going to be his championship. But right now, all of that seems in jeopardy, which is why we love the NBA Finals. We also love the NBA Finals because they give us moments like this. In a loss, Cam Johnson over P.J. Tucker. Jalen Rose, what did you think of this fantastic dunk from the young man?
Oh, I got you. This is what I thought. I was on my Eddie Kane, David Ruffin shout. Nights like this, I wish raindrops would fall.
You're the worst singer.
That's exactly what I said as it was happening. I saw the lane open up. And it was in slow motion. I was staring right at that angle. And PJ was slowly moving. Nights like this. And then all of a sudden you see PJ Tucker sitting on the floor like, yay, caught me.
Well, yeah, he did.
That's what happens when you actually play defense. See, I brag about not getting dunked on. But the B side of that is because you got to sacrifice your body. Do you know how much it hurts for a 6'9", 240-pound dude just to run as fast as he can to knee you in your chest and make you fall on your backside? I'm good. If I was doing that, I wouldn't be looking this good at my age. I had to preserve myself, dog.
Look, most defenders slide into the contact and try to get a charge. Jalen Rose would slide away from the contract and just let you dunk. That's how Jalen gets down. Jalen, Devin Booker played great in game one and game two, but he did not play great last night. He was 3 for 14 from the field. Do you think it was just him in his head, or was it something that the Bucks did to him defensively?
So this old school game, it's always good defense when they miss. So like, you can look at the tape and be like, oh, those are shots that he normally makes. But guess what would happen if no one was standing in front of him? He would make almost every shot. And so I want to give the defense a lot of credit, and he will respond. Having 10 points and Monty giving him a breather late in the game as they went on the run, he went small with CP3 and Payne to see if they were going to make a run. Hey, if they make a run, I'll get you back in there. If they don't, then we're going to get you ready for the next game. There was a level of a fatigue that he's been playing their starters heavy minutes, Ayton included, which probably attributed to some of his fouls. So I like how they used Booker late by letting him rest it out. I expect him to come back and respond. He's going to need to in the next game.
unlike normal NBA finals, there's actually an extra day between games 3 and 4 that I think will play into this and be a factor when it comes to the health of Giannis and fatigue and Booker and Aiden and things like that. The schedule is a little bit more spread out than normal, but I'm so excited for game 4 because game 3 gave the Bucks hope. And if they can win game 4, we have a 2-2 series as it heads back to Phoenix. We might even see a game 7.